What's good, and welcome to another episode of Car Talk with your boy Sense. I know it's been some time, man, but you know, been focusing on family, focusing on readjusting a couple plans, focusing on just how I want my new year to start out, you know what I'm saying? That being said, no apologies, but I'm back at it. Shit, man, what do we got going on? It's been so much going on. I think I'm gonna touch on a couple topics today, and one of them is this thing with the Tory and Megan Trout. Like, when these things happen, everybody's gonna have an opinion, right? That's natural. It's just like, that's who we are. We just give our opinion. This person did it. Nah, this person never did that. This person's lying. Okay, cool. All of us have our opinions on it. But I feel like the females right now are taking a super aggressive stance, as if they know absolutely for a fact, beyond a shadow of a doubt, what exactly took place. And I think that's like, I think that's a bias that shouldn't exist in society. You know what I'm saying? Like, when something happens involving a female, people automatically just take that, the female side. And it's confusing because, you know, this is a society where we're like pushing more and more for, you know, feminism, equality. But at the same time, it seems like, certain women want like specialized treatment. So everybody, absolutely everybody, is supposed to be presumed, innocent until guilty, unless it's a man and involving a woman, you know what I mean? Unless there's a case involving a man and a woman, and the man is the defendant. Yeah, I feel like the double standard is kind of crazy. So maybe we need more clarification on how this whole female empowerment thing is supposed to work. Is it just supposed to be, are women working towards equality, or are they working towards specialized treatment? And I just, I think that people need to relax a little bit, because not all women are innocent, and not all men are guilty. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, maybe wait for the results of the trial, because people are talking like they're there. Or they were there, and they know exactly what.
At the end of the day, whether it was bullet fragments or the actual bullet, he shot a gun in the direction of this woman, and that's unforgivable.
How the fuck do you know? How the fuck do you know? That's what we're at trial to find out. What are you talking about, bro? Where are these assumptions coming from? Tory said he didn't shoot Shorty, right? Shorty said she shot him. There's a bunch of weird misaligning things in between all of that that makes absolutely zero sense. For example, the foot being one of the most bone-filled and condensed areas of the body, and for anything to like go through that without, anyhow, let's just leave that alone, because now I'm introducing my own personal bias into the situation, right? And I don't want to do that. I have my own beliefs about the situation that doesn't need to be discussed here tonight. What needs to be discussed is just backing off of that situation until all of the evidence comes out. Y'all are crazy, man. Y'all are out here riding for this girl like you grew up with her, and it's a little bit wild. Lastly, we see Master P out here and his son having a dispute. First of all, I think it's unfortunate that it came out on the internet. You know, fortunate for anybody who's blogging and making content. Very unfortunate for the family, and me being a family man and a person with, you know, kids who are getting older in age. Every time I see something like this happen, it always makes me go, I really hope I have more communication with my kids than that, to the point where they feel like the only place that they can go to get resolution is the internet. So first of all, I just think that's, I don't want to say unnecessary, because maybe it was necessary. Because from the updates that I'm seeing now, it seems like some of the gripes and concerns that grown Romeo is having with his dad involving money have been resolved. So maybe the public shaming avenue worked for him, and maybe that was the only thing that would work, because from what he's saying, he's tried to speak to his father multiple times in private, right? One thing I don't like seeing is people saying, oh, you were spoon-fed and your dad don't owe you nothing and he gave you every opportunity and blah, blah, blah. This, that, and the third, just buying into one narrative. I think Romeo was pretty clear on expressing that he's not asking for handouts. He's just asking for the things that he worked for and deserves, like his album revenue. He has a Rap Snacks brand. He's supposed to be getting residuals off of that. I don't know the business behind it. I don't know what P's doing. I don't know what P's not doing. I don't know if he's actually giving him the residuals and he's squandering it. I don't know. All I'm going to do is give a hypothetical situation for both sides. So if what's happening is that P is not giving his son his just dues for the things that he has worked for and earned, or for a brand that is bearing his image or anything like that, if anybody else was to do that to anybody else in the culture, like if Lay's was to make a bag of chips with Jay-Z's face on it and try not to pay Jay-Z, we would all be like, oh, this is some fucked up shit, this is some racist shit, right? But because he's his father, like, that gives him some type of, immunity to having to pay his kids for using their image. I don't agree with that. You know what I mean? It was Shaq who sued his own son for, like, I think trying to use his name or his last name or something like that shit. So, you know what I'm saying? Let's get that out of the way, bro. It's regardless of regardless of what y'all think.
Come in. What are you waiting out there for, weirdo?
Regardless of what you what y'all think, that man worked for something. You know, as a kid, put in 6 albums. If there's residuals from those albums, if there's monies that haven't been paid, they should be paid. You know what I'm saying? There's no excuse for that. And if what's happening is that, you know, you've been getting paid, on the other side, if Romeo has been getting paid and he just doesn't feel like it's enough or he wants more or whatever the case may be, then, you know, that's unfortunate, bro. Like, you know what I mean? And it even more unfortunate is that your father, who's a billionaire, couldn't just say, look, whatever, you're my son. What do you want? 60, 60, 40, 70, 30. Let's do it. I don't care. I have enough money already. I made my money back from those albums like 20 years ago. That's cool. We're good. whatever. Is that cool? Does that make the situation better? Cool. I think that's sad that, because, like, I for sure I'm not putting business over my kid. Like, you know what I mean? Like, if it's a lesson to be learned, it's like, okay, we still have to recoup these funds because we didn't get that much off of this project, and we need to get the rest of the money off of this project, and that's not how business works. But after I get the money that we spent on that project back, I'll give you whatever you want. Cool. If you need to teach a lesson, cool. But, like, this is 20 years ago, fam. For sure, Romeo has paid off whatever he used out of marketing and finances. So I just don't feel like this shit should have ever came to light. I don't feel like, I don't feel like I wish that they had been able to resolve it privately. You know what I'm saying? But anyhow, I got some things to do personally, myself. My wife is over here waiting for me to finish, so I'm just gonna wrap it up. I appreciate y'all. You already know what time it is, family, money, everything. Let's get it, baby. Whoa!